In this video, we'll look at getting started with Closed Caption Creator version 7. We'll start by installing Closed Caption Creator. Go to closedcaptioncreator.com and scroll to the bottom of the page, where you'll find a link to the downloads page in the footer. Click the download link under the Mac icon in order to start downloading the latest version for Mac. Once the download is complete, install the application and launch it from the Applications folder. The first time you launch Closed Caption Creator, you will see the login screen, where you'll be required to log in using the same email you used when signing up for Closed Caption Creator. The first time you log in, it will also ask you to create a password. Once logged in, you'll be greeted by the Projects window. Because we don't have any saved projects, we'll go ahead and click the New Project button in the bottom right. This will open the Project Creation window. Here, we can give our project a name and select the source media we'll use for captioning. Your source media can either be a URL link from YouTube or Vimeo, or you can select a file from your local hard drive. In this example, we'll select an MP4 video from our local drive. Next, click the Create button. You'll see the video load in the player to the left. Before we start to caption our video, we'll want to set up a few keyboard shortcuts to make the process a little easier. You can open up the Shortcuts panel by going to Edit, Shortcut Keys. In this panel, we'll select the function we want on the left. Then, click the Input box on the right to add the shortcut. Inserting new events will default to the Tab key, but you can remap to whatever key you like. We'll add a shortcut for video playback. As well, we'll want to add shortcuts for reversing and fast-forwarding by 3 seconds. Close the Shortcuts menu by clicking away when you're done. Now, we're ready to start closed captioning our video. In this video, we'll create our text events manually. We have another video available that covers automatic captioning. We'll now select our first event in the editor on the right, and using the shortcut keys we set previously, we'll begin playback.
So what kind of stuff is really important when you're riding in the terrain park to get...
As the video plays, you'll want to type what you hear. However, you may need to pause the video in order to keep up. Another option is to change the playback speed of the video. This can be done using the settings option in the video player or by clicking the playback speed in the top toolbar. You'll see that the playback speed can be set to 1/4 all the way to 4 times real time. Once you've finished captioning your video, you'll want to go back and start adding in timestamps for each event. This can be done using the timing controls underneath the video player. We have another video available that covers timestamping more in depth. We'll start by going to the beginning of our video and selecting the first event. We'll turn off the preview play and video lock options. Next, we'll begin playback and click the Take Now button whenever we want an event to start.
So what kind of stuff is really important when you're riding in the terrain park? Do you guys have any special equipment, or is there anything that's really important when you're riding?
The last step will be to export our captions. You can either export your captions as a sidecar file, or you can export video with your captions burnt in as subtitles. We cover exporting video with subtitles in another video. So for this example, we'll export a sidecar file. Simply go to File, Export, Caption File. This will bring up the caption export window, where you can select your file format and click Export. Closed Caption Creator will ask you to select a location on your hard drive to save the new file. This completes the lesson on getting started with Closed Caption Creator. If you have any questions or require additional support, please visit closedcaptioncreator.com.